talking books.
الكتب المتحدثة.
كتب تتكلم.
The biggest challenge would be trying to change the perspectives of the Middle Eastern people in the way they consume reading.
The biggest need, without question, for such a project is to try to break down these huge misperceptions of the other.
It's learning about your fellow humans that are not alien at all.
We've definitely seen this through the magazine. 40% of our subscribers were non-Arab, which shows that non-Arab people are very interested in what's going on in the Arab world.
Okay, any translation, the challenges are keeping the essence, the energy of the story. It's not just translating the words, but translating the ideology that make up the sentence.
To know what an apple is not the same as to understand what the apple of my eye means. And you need people who really understand and have ideally lived in both an Arab country and English-speaking country.
I think because you need to work as well on the level of the consumer of the book. In the West here, we're used to the big bookshops. And in some of the big bookshops now, they've set up, you know, all these coffee shops. They create an environment.
The one thing I'd like to translate from Arabic into English, and that's children's books. And how would they read Harry Potter?
The main benefit is that it provides understanding of another culture. I think that's the fundamental benefit.
If they were to read literature and science and culture that showed that there was so much more that unites them historically and currently, and that really the majority of interaction between the two sides is positive. How do you encourage, particularly more people in the Arab world, to start reading more?
Audiobooks, audio tapes would be interesting here.
Since I've discovered the iPod, I've changed the way I'm reading books at the moment. I'm listening to them.
Historically and culturally, speech has been much more important than literature.
In Arab literary culture, what you say is very important, but how you say it is just as important. This is a very classical thing. There's a very funny anecdote that from a medieval book about a Bedouin who stood up on the minbar where the Imam leads the prayer on the Friday, and he said, "Oh, how wonderful was the person who said," and it was a verse from the Quran where the Quran quotes the devil, shall we say. And they said to him, "Oh, how can you say that? The devil said that." And he said, "But he said it so beautifully."